Ladies and gentlemen, WBF Asia Pacific Champion, Justin Derap!
World Boxing Federation Asia Pacific Champion, Justin Derap. The first thing that screams up the page with this kid, I've seen a lot of his fights. I've seen a lot of fights. He is very, very patient, very calculated.
Okay.
He's a southpaw with what I would call an educated jab, and has great footwork with hooks while moving backwards, which is really, really hard to do.
Wow.
I'm going to say, we're in for a great scrap.
You know, sometimes back in the day, look at a fighter and tell him that he can fight. They know that he can fight.
Representing Kazakhstan, Yelshat, Nikhemttolla!
They call this man the Kazakh warrior. Yelshat Nikhemttolla comes in with a record of 16 wins. 16 wins and no losses. He's got 5 KOs to his record, and that means he's had 11 decisions.
20 years old.
He's more of a, you know, if you see the way he fights, he's very long, he's very lanky, very rangy, but uses his jab very, very well. He's got a very, very educated jab.
Okay.
And he took on a Filipino southpaw in Alfante, very similar to his opponent tonight in 2020, very similar in approach and style, and managed to get the win against him. He's patient and technical, so we might actually see a very high quality technical scrap.
An educated jab.
An educated
jab. Man. Oh my God.
Yes. I can surprise a few people from time to time.
Oh my goodness. Educated jab. That's what it is.
Are we going to find out out of these men, who has the more educated jab?
Yes.
That can set up the range, the fight, the pace of the fight. Yeah. But from the pace of the entire night that we've been seeing, it's been manic so far.
Absolutely. I mean, man, I love every minute of it. Man, I've seen a lot of fight cars in Dubai.
Yeah, this is the greatest job in the world.
This is awesome.
Greatest job in the world.
Only thing, we're missing some peanuts and popcorn.
A cup of coffee would be good, though.
Oh, yeah.
That'd be good.
That's all right. But no, man, it's I love it.
Waiting for the final introductions inside the ring with Jared Kyle.
Ladies and gentlemen, fighting out of the red corner, he weighed in at 54 kilograms. His professional record, 9 wins, 1 loss. Fighting out of Calbayog City, Philippines, the WBF Asia Pacific champion and the Philippine title champion, make some noise for Justin Derap! And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. His professional record, 16 wins, 1 loss. He weighed in at 53.5 kilograms, representing Kazakhstan, the former entrant WBC champion, the Kazakh warrior, Yelshat Nikhemttolla! Ladies and gentlemen, as the action begins, the referee for the fight, Marat Shabalev.
Man, that was a that was a championship entrance from a championship championship ring announcer. Man.
Yes.
Jared has been working with him for over 10 years. Incredible.
Okay.
That's got me in the mood. Now
I
know it's a title fight.
I like him. I like what I see.
I like what I see too. And here we go. As both these contenders face off, Justin Derap from the Philippines taking on Yelshat Nikhemttolla from Kazakhstan. And, you know, this fight is in the bantamweight division, so guys, that's a much lower weight. So you're going to see a lot of blurs. You're going to see a lot of fast movement. You're going to see a lot of great technique. Yeah. Because I've noticed this seeing the heavier fighters, even though they, because of the fact that they pack a lot of power, you don't see a lot of clean technique.
No, you don't.
With the lighter weight classes, you see a lot of clean technique. And we talked about the educated jab of Nikhemttolla, and you can see him landing it over and over again. Justin Derap, though, staying patient here. This is going to be a chess match.
Chess game, exactly.
On cue, you said it, Joe.
That's what it is.
And it's like a chess game because both of these guys, they need to be careful here. But one wrong move and boom, your lights can go out. Justin Derap, though, has some serious power. He's knocked somebody down with a single shot to the liver in his last fight. I saw that fight. It was, I think it was a classic showcase against Robert Atwin Abitin in 2019.
Oh, yeah?
And he had a great fight and showed great body work, but it was that single shot to the liver which just knocked him down.
Oh, my.
And he's confident about the power in his hands. He's willing to stand and trade, but when the time is right.
Right.
But right now he needs to take his time, establish his range and his timing.
Absolutely.
Especially against such a technical striker in Derap and Yelshat, both of these guys.
His name is Yelshat, right, in the red?
Yeah.
He's standing up a little bit too high. I mean, I'm looking for Justin to come across with that hook.
There you go. On cue, you got it. But look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah.
5-punch jab combination. Just pouring it out there over and over. Oh, beautiful stiff left hook by Yelshat. Mm-hmm. Oh, beautiful counter coming in, stepping in. Caught Derap.
Yeah, he caught him good.
Man, just over and over and over is that jab. And great technique with his striking as well.
Yes, he is. Look, I would like to see him utilize that jab. Shoot the jab to the shoulders. Shoot it to the left shoulder. Shoot it to the right shoulder. Then drop the left hand. Give him a different look. Got good foot movement.
Yelshat, the faster of the two fighters, that's for sure. Yeah. He's got better foot movement. Mm-hmm. Able to escape the counters
exactly.
of Derap so far.
Yes. Yes.
Derap looks like he's looking to reset here. He's just taking his time, looking to establish that range, that distance. And there you go. That was his left hook to the body. That's what got him his success in his last few fights.
Good body shot.
Great first round.
Let's see. Awesome. Let's see who set the tempo, man. Keep it going.
Yeah, I think right now it's Yelshat who set the tempo early in that fight. Yeah. Landed the better combinations, was certainly the more crisper striker.
More creative.
But too close, though. That's what happens when you have guys who are so up there in competition.
Yeah.
You know, you got guys who are so close to one another, it's hard to tell. And I'm glad on days like this that I'm not a judge. I don't want to be a judge for a fight like this.
Yeah.
Take a look at the replay, the highlights. I mean, Derap had some success early on, which had Yelshat smiling. And usually smiling is a sign of, that means, yeah, I got, you know. He's trying to smile it off, but he got tagged.
He's more elusive. You know what I mean? He got that he can move a little bit better.
Yeah. Yelshat's got the better footwork, the better head movement.
Yeah.
And it kind of started getting better towards the end of the fight, towards the end of the round.
Exactly.
It took a few moments to, you know, figure out his timing, his range, and then started catching Derap as he came in.
But what I don't like is that lead uppercut.
The lead uppercut?
You set yourself up. Shoot it off the jab.
I like the lead uppercut, but it's because you know what? The rear uppercut, you see it coming. There you go. We need to put you on camera to show us how you do that, because I can see it right next to me, but the rest of the audience. Beautiful overhand right by
Derap. You saw it. That's all about it. You saw it.
Derap having some good success. The minute Yelshat stepping in with that jab to the body, he's timing that overhand left.
Drop that left here. Exactly.
Man, the speed of both these guys. Good body work there by Derap a moment ago.
See, what I like about Yelshat, he can box and he can punch, man.
Yeah. There's such a difference. You know, you're the one who explained that difference to me today. There's boxers and then they're punchers.
One-dimensional individuals.
Yeah, but you know what? One-dimensional individuals sometimes are scary because they do that one thing so well. They catch you with that one thing across 40 minutes.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it's going to be a bad night.
Yes, yes.
I've seen that in so many fights where the fighter A is losing for like 6 rounds and then out of nowhere, bang, one shot, which rattles you so badly.
Especially if you're punching. You know what I mean?
And Derap certainly finding some success with that left. But Yelshat getting on his bike here.
Yelshat felt his power. So, yes, he's getting on the bicycle a little bit. He wants to mix it up every now and again.
And the smart thing Yelshat is doing, he's circling away from that left.
There you go.
He's circling to his wrong side. But Derap, a fighter like Derap, he's got more weapons than one. He's got that right hook coming in as well.
Mm-hmm.
I think he's going to punish him every time to the body if he's coming in that way.
Okay, let's see what's happening.
See, there you go. Look
at that body shot right
Boom.
There.
To the body.
Where your head a little bit more. See what they're not doing right now. They're throwing punches. They're not thinking. They're just throwing punches. You know what I mean? You set it up. 2-on-3 jab. If I hit you with a right hand, left hook, I'm going to finish with a double and triple jab.
But do you see something that's happening here? Since Derap started landing those body shots, Yelshat slowed down a little bit. He's standing in front of him, and that's giving Derap some confidence. Yeah. There you go. He was in the last round, he wasn't touching Yelshat.
No. Yeah, exactly.
The minute Good he
point.
Landed those body shots, he started,
Great
okay,
point.
He's
Great
got
point.
His attention.
Great point.
And instead of following him, chasing him, he's cutting him off. Now.
Right. But he had to keep his hands up, keep that left hand up, man.
Again, Justin these exchanges.
Yeah. There you go. Now he put it up.
What I like is that he's making use of his opportunities. When he gets the opportunity to hit him, he's not letting him go.
No, right.
Again, to the body. He's turning away. Good, I'm going to touch you.
But if you look at their feet as they throw punches,
yeah.
Neither one of them are twisting their feet, turning their hips. They're just throwing arm shots.
They're not heavy shots.
You know what I mean? They ain't turning.
Yeah, there's no
body.
Hip in it, yeah.
You know what I mean?
But maybe, you know, it's just a long fight. It's 8 rounds. It's a strategy. Maybe they're looking to conserve energy. Maybe he's trying to make him feel up. And then maybe 1 or 2 punches, just like that right hook to the body. He put his whole body into that.
Turn him hips, though. Get him out of there.
Oh, very nice. Oh,
no.
Whoa. That was a shot clearly after the bell. Oh, no, that was clearly after the bell. And I think Yelshat was a little angry because he was getting tagged in that round.
We would have been at it.
Yeah.
They had to pull me off of him.
If you were in the corner?
No,
yeah.
We would have been at it. Hit me with that shot, I'm going to get you back.
Oh, my God. Take a look at that round. Yelshat started out strong again. A continuation from his pace in the first round.
Ooh, right hook, left hand.
It's a good combination to Derap and Derap.
Again, see?
Yeah, that was the start of the round, but Yelshat still had the pace. But eventually, Derap came back. He started making this a dirty fight. And sometimes that's what punchers do.
See that body shot.
Yeah, those two, the 1-2 to the body, that's what woke up. You know, Derap got up, and Yelshat didn't like that one bit.
Good action, man.
This is some great, great fighting, and Yelshat didn't like that at all. Started getting tagged with that overhand left.
Yes, yeah.
And you saw it in his expression. His expression changed.
Tremendous.
And the end was just unfortunate. Sadly, there's no room for cheap shots in any of these sports.
None whatsoever.
But now this gets interesting. Now, stepping in, Derap immediately countered Yelshat. Again, throwing a jab to the body. Sense of urgency in Yelshat's eyes, though.
Yes, it is.
This one's a tough one to score. I'd be a round apiece so far.
Yeah, me too. I got it at 1-1.
Derap showing some great composure here, but Yelshat trying to establish that jab again. Slow down the fight. Bring it back to his pace because he can't stand and bang. He can't play just in Derap's game.
No, exactly.
There are only so many body shots you can take. Good return fire from Yelshat. Derap trying to... This is a nice trick here because he's trying to bait him in.
Yeah, he is.
Tell me, Chul, sometimes the fighters find out that they're not too affected by someone's power. They use a lot of mind games and tactics.
Yes.
To goad them.
Yes, they do. But you got to be an intelligent fighter. You know what I'm saying?
And that's the thing. I think that's what Yelshat probably might be irritated with.
Good body
that he
shot.
Was baited into doing that in the last round.
Right.
He's looking a lot better this round, though. But those thundering shots
Jared
to the body.
Is digging that body.
But Yelshat returning fire with those shots. He's going back to the body as well. But I think physically, I think Derap is the stronger puncher.
Yeah.
He's landing the harder shots. Nice 1-2 to the head by Derap. And both these men, overhand left. But Derap immediately back.
No quitting Derap, though. Ooh, good right hook.
Oh, another right hook here. Derap playing possum, or he might be actually hurt here?
Only double and triple up the hooks. Triple it up, come on.
Yelshat feeling the flow here as he's starting to land and open up on Derap in this third round. 5 rounds to go, but will it go the distance? Time will tell.
Good excitement.
Beautiful technique and excitement in this round. I love the way he's throwing out five jabs at a time. One, two, three, four, five.
I take my hat off to both of these gentlemen.
Man, both these guys. Oh, big combination
there.
Look at
them. They're putting it together, though. You can tell their skill levels.
The skill levels are right up there. Both these men have been champions.
Absolutely. Absolutely, man. And they're both hungry, and they want it.
And look, there's no quitting there. Derap has eaten a lot of shots, but he's stepping in. Mm-mm. And they're going shot for shot.
Shot for shot, man. Shot for shot.
Big overhand right. Shot. Look at that. Yeah. Look at Yelshat smile.
Say, yeah, okay. User said, come on. Come on.
Now they're stepping into the pocket. But, man, you know, one of the most scary things I've seen is a fighter who can just still chase you after taking punishment.
Yeah, yeah.
And Derap is after him like a dog on a bone. Round's over and they're still going at it.
They're going at it, man.
Wow, what an incredible contest so far. God, jeez, this is awesome. Hard to score. This is really, really hard. But I think it's now leaning slightly towards the Kazakh warrior.
You think so?
Yelshat. Yeah, you know, it's hard. Because it's
they got
to
revive him. I'm glad the corner man gave him that cold war to put it on his face to revive Oscar.
I mean, look at some of the highlights of that round. I think Yelshat turned it around a little bit in this round. He started to take control with that
range.
There
were so many combinations. They both were going back and forth. They're going back and forth with it.
I mean, that's where it becomes difficult to score this as a judge. But you can't. Sometimes you can land 30 small shots and then
you
one hard.
You gotta watch the combination too. Some of them punches are being caught by Justin. See, them shots getting caught.
But then at the same hand, Justin Derap missing a lot of combinations of his own as well. But the minute he had him pinned against the fence,
he started making fight.
But if this time Yelshat started landing fire, you hit me to the body, I hit you back to the body.
Yeah.
So it's going to get interesting as we step into the fourth round.
Look at this here, excitement.
Halfway point of this incredible fight. We always knew this had the potential to be fight of the night.
Absolutely.
And so far it's living up to its name. So many great performances tonight. It's going to be hard to choose the fight of the night.
Everybody put on a spectacular performance, man. Oh, good uppercut.
Beautiful uppercut. But immediately
I said usually. You know, I've been training Anthony Joshua.
You've been training Anthony Joshua?
Yeah.
Now you're just showing off.
I'm just, you know, you mind me. I said the name wrong. That's what it came up.
This one's a very tough one to figure out because the minute Derap is stepping in, he's taking a few shots and he's landing some shots to the body. But I think the initial effect that Derap had on Yelshat is kind of, I think, in my opinion, is starting to wear off a little.
Yeah, yeah.
Because Yelshat is timing him a little better. Mm-hmm. He's keeping him at more at range.
Taking him with that jab. Like you said before, that jab is a pest.
But then he steps in again and catches him with a 1-2.
Exactly.
It's so close. Again, 1-2 by Yelshat.
Boom, boom. He's working.
Oh, man. Beautiful dig to the
in
body a second ago.
Ooh. Again,
boom. Straight again to the body. That jab. 3-4-5 jab. He's just
busy.
Over and over.
He's a much busier fighter right now.
Man, I think I need to be a referee because the workout that he's getting in this fight, the referee is incredible. I think I need to be a referee. I'll get fit ripped in a couple of days.
Oh,
look at that. Big overhand right. Stiffened up Yelshat for a second.
And he know it. He know it.
And he knows it. His body language has changed immediately.
Yes.
Stepping forward.
But he got to be careful.
No, he's not.
Be careful with that left hand. Watch, I'm telling you. It's coming. I told you.
It's coming. But Derap knows. That's the thing. That's the interesting thing. As a fighter, if you know you can hurt someone, you know you can turn it up. Yelshat is putting everything into the shots, but he hasn't been able to crack Derap yet.
Exactly.
But that shot to the body, one shot to the body from Derap gets Yelshat backing up.
Yep.
So when you score it, what do you score it on? You look at damage as well. You look at reactions from fighters as well, not just the points that are based on the strikes landed.
Right. All those were misses.
Yelshat now.
And when you miss, man, it takes a lot out you.
Yeah, and Yelshat is trying to land. He's trying to hit him with his hardest shot.
Everything
trying to get him respect him at
everything
some point.
Everything he got in that, he's trying. But sometimes
big right hook.
Look,
you can see that stiffened
that
him up.
That hurt him a little bit.
Oh, it stiffened him up immediately.
Got hit with it again.
Oh, look at that. He's leaning on him a little bit.
But
for
ain't
a
no
second.
Quit in him.
Hey, no, there's no quit.
No
they
quit
call
in
him,
him.
The Kazaki warrior for a reason. It almost knocked out his mouthpiece. Oh, wow.
Love
One,
it, man.
Two
Love
attempt
it, man.
Again.
Love it. Here he comes.
But look at the body language. Derap is, look at his eyes, they're clear. His cardio is clear.
Yeah.
And Yelshat though, the amount of effort he's putting in to avoiding and constantly moving backwards is so hard to do.
Do we look at it as a boxer or we look at it as aggression?
Yeah, if you look at it as ring aggression, Derap should get the points for that. And I think because of that big shot, you know, you can land 40 jabs that just pitter-patter, and then that one shot will score more on the judges' scorecard. And this is the story of the round. Now we
The judges also, some judges like boxing, some of them like punching.
Exactly. If I was a judge, I mean,
that's where that one dimensional don't come affect with my fighter. We can punch and we can box.
But look at that immediately when Derap turns it up. The minute he starts swinging to the body and the head, it changes the game altogether.
They just don't like each other, do they?
They don't like each other at all. I don't know. We might see some sportsmanship after the fight, but we're in the fifth round now. I don't see any love right now. Corner's clear. Here we go. Fifth round.
Every punch had bad intentions.
It's got bad intentions written all over it. I like the way how Yelshat starts every round. He goes technical. He starts looking to stick and move and land. But it's the body work of Derap.
Yeah.
Watch out for that left hook to the body. He's won a few fights that way. And I like the fact that he's willing to take shots, you know, to step in, to get that chance in the pocket.
But it can be good to a certain extent. Because the name of the game is a hit and don't be hit.
Yeah. But at the same time, sometimes that's the way you go in a technical fight. You know, sometimes technical fighters...
I love it.
Yeah, come on. I love it. You know I love it. I know you love it. See, there you go. Immediately. Derap lands a hard shot and Yelshat starts getting back on his bite. He starts moving backwards.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah.
Whereas every time Yelshat hits Derap, Darup's still in the pocket. He's still standing in front of his face.
Right there.
He's right there. There's not one back step. But there you go. There you go. The minute he lands a combination, he's got Yelshat backing
up. Cleaner shots. That's what we look at. He got Yelshat is landing some good body shots.
Great body shots. And this is scoring points in the eyes of the judges.
Absolutely.
But I'm pretty sure Derap and his corner know. They got an eye on the clock. They got an eye on knowing how many rounds they're down in the pocket.
Yeah.
And they might be right, they might be wrong, who knows? But sometimes in a long fight, strategy is all that counts. He might be looking to turn it up in the last few.
Yes. You said it
right. Oh, big left hook. Another right hook, sorry.
Good feint. Look at him. Yeah. Should have went to the body.
I think Yelshat has been missing more and more. As the fight wears on, he starts off every round very, very strong for the first minute
and he fades
or so.
In the last minute.
And just about in the last minute and a half, he starts to fade. And I think Derap knows that, and that's when he saves his energy to turn it up a little bit.
Both of you guys are in great shape, man.
Great shape. And oh, Derap landed a beautiful right hook over the top.
Shape.
And Yelshat coming back with fire. Incredible shape. I can't say this more. You're absolutely right, Joe. The kind of shape that they're in is, you know, if you're not trained well, if you're not been through a good camp, you've not done the right things, you're not going to be able to take that kind of damage and punishment.
No, you can't, man. These guys are taking it to another level.
Beautiful five-punch combination by Yelshat. But Derap now looking to do some damage with a few shots of his own. Yelshat doing a much better job avoiding the strikes of Derap in this round. 10 seconds remaining in this fifth round.
Derap is closing the gap, though. He's trying to close that gap. Okay.
Good flurries. Oh, big shot, return fire. No, this is what we mean. At the belt.
Those were good flurries, but it wasn't no real punches.
That's the hard thing. Now, in the judge's eyes, you're going to look at a seven punch combination.
Yeah.
But then he returned with a shovel punch and an overhand left, and which stunned his opponent.
Exactly.
How do you score that?
Yeah.
Because if you look at the body language between the two fighters that we're seeing in the corner, Derap is looking the fresher fighter.
Yeah, absolutely. I was going to say that, man.
He's smiling in the camera.
He's a much fresher fighter.
Yelshat is so much harder working off your heels. Moving backwards and fighting is one of the hardest things. And the sting behind his right hooks and left hooks.
What is it, 8 rounds or 10 rounds?
It's 8 rounds. The championship fights are 10 rounds.
Okay.
And
this championship stuff here.
This is real. I mean, I would see a title on all these fights.
Absolutely.
Give them all a belt, I say.
This championship stuff here.
No, this is real championship stuff. I mean, both these guys coming. I mean, Justin Derap is a Philippines title champion and a World Boxing Federation Asia Pacific champion.
Okay.
And Nikhemttolla was the interim WBC champion as well. So both these guys have that championship experience. It feels like a championship fight.
Yeah, it definitely feels like a championship fight.
We're in round number six, just two more rounds to go. And so far, well, you know, this is a tricky game that Derap is playing now.
Yeah.
Because if the judges are the kind of judges that are going to score it on, you know, technically, like with the amount of strikes landed,
right.
Sure, Yelshat is up on the scorecards.
Yeah, absolutely.
Derap is waiting for that moment, and he's cracking. He's catching him in those moments.
Yeah, he is.
But if out of three rounds, if in a three-round fight, in a three-minute round, if you're going to be big
shot.
Dick to the body, if you're going to let go for around a minute and a half and then do some damage to at the end, big shots to the body there, and he dug in hard with that
one. Yes, he did.
But Yelshat, man, hit the pace that big left hook that landed for Derap. Got Yelshat on the back pedal, but how impressive is that seven jab? Jab, 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 over and over again. So in my eyes, I think he's scoring shots. He's scoring points at this point.
The more effective punches is coming from Justin.
Very good point. But it also depends how the judges look at it.
Exactly.
Because if he can't finish him, then suddenly it goes down to the points.
Exactly.
I don't envy the judges.
Both of them look good, man.
Digs to the body. He's got some very, very good hooks to the body. And the kind of conditioning that these guys are in, I mean, I don't see a knockout to the face here.
It's a hard fight to score because the first couple of rounds, Yelshat was coming on.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? The later part of rounds, Derap is starting to put his punches together.
Yeah, and it's on cue in this fight. After the halfway point of the round, Derap takes over.
Yeah.
So it's a nightmare to score.
Back and forth, man. Action fight.
But you can see Yelshat is breathing out of his mouth. He's getting a little tired here. He knows he's got two rounds to go.
But big, like nice one-two. He's touching him with that jab, that one-two. You know what I mean?
Oh, but that's not even fading. It's not even phasing Derap. Derap doesn't respect his power at this point. He's like, okay, hit me with your hardest shot, but I know I got you with my body hooks.
But what Derap has to do is learn how to cut the man off. You can't let the man run all around.
That's
the
some ring. Great advice, yes. I think at the start of the fight,
there
he was
you
cutting
go.
Off.
See? He heard me, huh?
Yeah, he heard. They're all hearing you. They all hear you. But he's doing such a great job of, I think in the start of the fight, he was cutting him off a lot better.
Yeah.
And in that second round especially, where he cut him off and started landing some combinations, there you go, over the top. But man, what a chin on Yelshat. He's catching him with that right hook as Yelshat turns to his left.
Yes.
Look at that. Hands down now for a second with Yelshat. Yelshat might be getting tired here.
You see it.
And look at Derap. He's loading up on that left hook.
He's the much stronger fighter right now.
Big left hook. Right hook to the body. Wow.
Got a bloody nose. He's the much
stronger
fighter.
First blood. Yeah. First blood, baby. First blood. It took six rounds, but I think Derap put a stamp on that round towards the end. That's the thing, when a referee sees his body language as well. You know, you see your hands drop. You see him backpedaling a lot more. It doesn't look that great.
Exactly.
Have you seen fights sometimes that went, you know, it was competitive to like the sixth and the seventh round, and then suddenly one big round? You know, it's not just the knockdown or the points. It also mentally a fighter can break in that round. One bad round is horrible. We've seen a lot of, in fact, the best example we gave you was Tyson and Douglas.
Yeah.
When Douglas hurt him once, Tyson knocked him down a couple of times.
Tyson with that shot, went back to the corner. Right.
Yeah.
Turned around and when Douglas got up, he said, "Oh boy."
He didn't believe it because
nobody got
up from Tyson's shots.
Nobody.
And right now, both these men are just putting on a clinic here.
Spectacular performance by both of them.
Much respect to both these guys.
Yes.
Round number
I'm
seven.
I'm having fun with you commentating tonight, man.
Thank you, sir.
I'm serious.
Thank you, sir. It's incredible the way Yelshat is just, you know, he goes back to that game plan over and over.
Left hand, look at that left hand again.
That left hand is his moneymaker. is, you know, and he brings it out. It's not like he's winging it every second. He's setting it up.
He's
not showing his hand all the time.
Setting it up.
And he's coming over the body. He's coming. He's waiting for his moments. He's waiting for him to get tired because landing that, you know, keeping that jab up for so long is exhausting.
It can be if you don't practice it.
Yeah.
If you do anything repetitiously, it becomes natural.
Yeah. But it's got to be disheartening after a point, knowing that you've hit your opponent with the best shot.
And he's still coming at you.
Yeah. And, you know, both these men are hungry. They're both young, both looking to make their mark. They're just 20
years old. Man, yeah.
They've got their whole lives, their whole careers
yet
to go.
They really don't have that man strength yet. And when sometimes
big left hand.
And then sometimes when they say the man strength, it's the mentality. You know what I mean?
That's true. You know, we didn't see Canelo get into his man strength till the last 4 years. And he's been fighting since forever.
That mindset is like, can't nobody beat me.
Man, Derap,
these guys are going at it. Look at him.
And Derap doing some good damage in this fight. But Yelshat is finding it harder and harder to keep Derap off him. My God. How is Yelshat still standing? Big right hook there. Looking to separate.
He's holding on.
Smart move by Yelshat. He's looking, holding on. He might be hurt here.
There's no power on his punches right now.
No, you can see that jab isn't making. It's not touching him anymore.
It's not enough to hold Derap back. No, it's not enough.
Man, he's got a chin. He's eaten everything Yelshat threw at him.
Yes, he is.
And this is going to be a really fun fight. This is just buying time at this point.
By holding the fighter down by the neck, it takes a lot out of him. Good left hand.
Right hook by Yelshat. And immediately, the minute he lands, sends him stepping backwards. But do not count Yelshat out. This man is a warrior. They call him a Kazakh warrior for a reason.
You better not count him out.
And, we can't count anybody out. We don't know how it's going to be scored. Because in the judges,
that clean shot. Yeah. He got that back. He got it back,
But that's the thing. You mentioned it earlier. But
look
at that. Yelshat caught him. Ow! Wow. Man. These guys are going at it.
You would think they're fighting for a world title.
Maybe they are. You never
Maybe
know.
They are.
Maybe,
yeah.
You know, all this is practice.
Yeah, stomping ground. I don't know. But it's a great fight, man.
Oh,
great
my God. This is an incredible fight.
Great entertainment. Come on. Let's go.
Incredible action that's happening in the seventh round. The bell.
Yeah, but Derap, he in shape, man.
He's in.
Justin is in shape, man.
No, it's a combination of being in shape as well as you know, the mindset. The mindset, again, him being in shape, and also realizing that, you know what, I eat a couple of shots of this guy, I'm not worried about his power anymore.
Yes.
And the longer the fight goes, you get number and number.
Yes.
You feel it tomorrow, that's for sure.
Oh, absolutely.
You feel it tomorrow, that's for sure.
Oh, they feel it now. But most definitely tomorrow, absolutely.
Most definitely tomorrow. And then, see, just the back and forth. You know, it's Yelshat lands the technical shots, landing the jab over and over, but it's not damaging Derap. But one right hook from Derap is sending Yelshat backwards. But last round of this fight, this is the last round.
Okay,
the
eighth
final round coming up.
Yelshat need to come forward.
Yeah, you know Yelshat is.
I think this is gonna be an exciting round.
This is gonna be, and this was a big round for Derap because he caught him more times than he had ever caught him.
Yeah.
I think they're gonna go both. Both are gonna
this
go full
great
steam,
fight, man.
Here we go.
You hate to see anybody lose this one.
No, it's going to be sad to see whoever's going to lose in this fight. I just hope nobody gets robbed. That's all. But I'll tell you what. You know, one person who didn't get robbed was the crowd. See, again, he's gone back to school. He's working that jab over and over. Standing, scoring points.
Putting on a cleaner right now.
And Derap again, waiting for his moment, waiting for that time. But in the eighth round, he's not worried about emptying out the gas tank. Yelshat is just going to go for it now. He's going to keep doing this. Get on his bike. Get out of range.
Yeah.
And Derap here is for some reason, is not unloading.
No, he's not.
I don't know. Maybe sometimes, you know, he thinks he's up on the scorecard somewhere. Derap again, now looking to score. This is a big body shot by Derap. Oh, big left hook.
So he comes on at later part of the round.
It's literally after the first minute. Yeah. It's literally after the first minute.
Exactly.
It's like I think.
Exactly.
I think maybe he realizes that it's the fight started after the first minute.
Yeah, exactly.
Incredible. That's how it's been. Comes over again with that right hook.
Hmm. Turned it under.
Great combination by both these men as we get ready for a close to this fight. But man, look at that. Yelshat is bleeding all over the place. His nose is busted up. And if they count damage, it's going to get interesting.
Let's see what happened in the last minute, man.
Last minute of this round. And it's been a cruel 7 rounds and 2 minutes for both these warriors. Look at that. Yelshat unloading. Mm-hmm. But needs to be careful. But this is where Derap is his most dangerous. He will swing for the fences and look to take your head off.
That's what he's doing now.
But man, what a fight. Just a minute, about a minute left in this fight. And these men are exhausted.
They are. They are.
Here we go, Derap again. I think, you know, he's just waiting for that moment, but I don't know how to score this fight. It's going to be very weird. Who you got so far, Chil?
Man, these guys both put on a spectacular performance. Man.
Spectacular
it
performance. Incredible
awesome,
performance.
Awesome. Like I mean, you say, it is hard to judge.
It is. It's really, really hard. If you
it's
look
really
at
hard.
It from the sense of damage,
really
it's,
really
you know, Derap did had landed the harder shots, the more meaningful shots. But Yelshat did count, scored more on the scorecards, landed the more, you know, landed more shots.
He did.
In total. Interesting to see what, because this fight is going to go to the judges. Yeah. Just a few seconds remaining. And both these warriors could not be denied.
Ain't both no quit them in them. Ain't no quit in them.
Oh, man, what an incredible
ain't
fight.
No quit in them.
Wow.
Awesome.
Incredible action across 8 rounds. Like you said, Chil, this could very easily have been a title fight. Very, very easily.
I don't know why.
I know.
Should have been.
Maybe next time we give them a different belt. We give them like a BMF belt.
Title shot. 12 round.
Incredible action as we saw throughout the fight. Over and over. But there was a pattern to this fight. We saw the first minute and a half being dominated by Yelshat, the Kazakh warrior. And then Derap coming back with body shots and head shots that looked more damaging.
Yes.
Now it all goes down to see how the judges look at this fight. Because, okay, now, Chil, come on. Truth time. If you're a judge, what's your take on it?
Well, my take on it is, like I said, both of them fought their butt off. You know what I mean? But I would have been able to draw.
I would say 76, 74.
I'd be able to draw.
I'd be able to draw.
But
it's hard, man. It's hard. It's really hard. I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen.
Yelshat was pity-patting. Justin was giving him body shots.
Yelshat was maybe at the start.
But it was great, man. It was a great performance.
Great performance.
This is one, it's hard to do.
Hey, man, what if it's a draw?
That's what I said.
What if it's a draw?
Hey.
Could be.
Might be a split decision.
I think it's a split decision.
Split decision. Not no unanimous.
Definitely could be. Yeah. If it's unanimous, I mean, then I guess everybody was watching different fights.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Well, we still got time for the judge's decision.
The first part of the fight was going useless. He was winning.
Yes, yeah, he was.
He was winning.
You know, he won the first round. Yelshat won the first round, and then Derap came back in the second.
He was coming back and forth.
Back and forth. 50-60 loss. And then now it just comes down to what the judges think. And sometimes the judges are taking so long to give a decision.
You know what it is.
I don't like it when judges
you know
take
what
that
it
long.
Is. You know what it is.
Oh, man. It's going to be very interesting now to see what's going to happen as we still wait for the judges' scorecards.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 8 rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. The judges scored about 74-79, 74-78, and 75-77. For your winner by unanimous decision, the Kazakh warrior, Yelshat Nikhemttolla.
We called it. We called it. We, you know, that's what we said. This is 78-74. But I expected it to be a closer fight. It's, you know, it's the shots.
He deserved it.
Absolutely. Both these men deserve a win. It's sad that one has to lose. Because after a performance like that, they definitely deserve a win. But it was just show of sportsmanship between these two men. Landed after the bell and stuff, but that's all done now. Fight's over. I want to see these boys throw down again.
I would love to see it.
I want to see this a world
game.